Hello, everyone. I want to talk about giving more people more access to more knowledge. All of us need access to knowledge, right? Be it people like you who want to know more about art, or be it the parent at home who wants to know more about the sickness of their child, or a politician who wants to know more about politics in a very different part of their world. And one of the ways many people get access to knowledge is Wikipedia. How many of you have ever used Wikipedia? Yay, very good. So now keep your hands up if you've ever edited Wikipedia. Wow, yeah, not too bad. Very good. So 500 million people read Wikipedia every month. That's an impressive number. But there are a few problems. And it starts with this number. We have nearly 300 Wikipedias. But only 161 of them, for example, have an article about Pablo Picasso. This means people who don't speak one of those 161 languages don't have access to this knowledge. This is much better than the rest of the internet, but it's still pretty bad. And if you look at this, this shows the same problem in a much more visible way. This is English Wikipedia articles that have a geo-coordinate. So for example, the city has a dot of light on this map. The Eiffel Tower has a dot on this map. Things like that. Now, English Wikipedia, you can see a lot of the world, right? But take a look at Spanish Wikipedia. Or Russian. Or Farsi. Or Japanese. For some reason, Japanese Wikipedia really likes Italy. Now, what you can see is that we really have a problem because we don't give everyone access to the same amount of knowledge. And Wikimedia started developing Wikidata to address this challenge. What is Wikidata? It's a knowledge base. So we store data about the world that anyone in an open and collaborative way, so that anyone can contribute, can use, can edit it. We do this in a multilingual way. So you enter data and someone else can access this data in their language. And it's a secondary database, which is really important for Wikipedia because we try to not figure out the one single truth, but instead collect what other sources say. So for example, if you want to build a central knowledge base for Wikipedia and have people agree on, for example, the number of inhabitants of Israel, really difficult. So we don't do that. We just say, okay, this book says that, this research says that, and we collect all that, and then people can build their own opinion based on what we have. So what does this look like in practice? This is a screenshot of the page about the Mona Lisa, the painting, in Wikidata. What you can see is the name and descriptions in different languages, and links to different Wikipedias and other Wikimedia projects like Wikinews, Wikimedia Commons, Wikiquote, and so on. And a lot of statements saying something about the Mona Lisa. For example, that is a painting by Leonardo da Vinci, where it is held currently, and so on. And if you scroll a bit further down, you find a number of identifiers, so links to other databases, institutions, and so on, that also have information about the Mona Lisa. And we do this for, I think, nearly 18 million things in the world right now. So once you have this, you can do a really amazing things. You can use it as a data hub, so other people can use this data to build things. Or as a data source. You can use it as a data hub, so people can come to us and find other databases that have more information. And you can use our concepts to tag your documents, images, and so on, for example. Let me give you some concrete examples what people do. This is on English Wikipedia, the article about the South Pole Telescope. And this is what we call an info box on Wikipedia. And this is built completely based on information that is in Wikidata. So any other Wikipedia could now go and pretty easily have at least this basic information about the South Pole Telescope as well. Or you can go to our query service where you can query all the data we have and make, for example, nice visualizations. This is a query for all the world UNESCO heritage sites that we have in Wikidata. And you can do many more visualizations and all kinds of queries. There are fun examples if you want to look at them. This is a tool called Histopedia. Their motto is the we build a timeline of everything. Yes, which is pretty cool, right? So this is not quite a timeline of everything. It just works by Leonardo da Vinci, but basically they allow you to query what's in Wikidata and build nice visual timelines for education and so on, and explore what's behind all these things on your timeline. Oh, here's another thing. It's called the Sum of All Knowledge, which started as the Sum of All Paintings. And basically, it's a project where people collect data about paintings in well-known institutions. So for example, this is about the Prado and all the paintings that are there, where it is, and there's more information about it. So access to the information that Wikidata has in a very visual and nice way. Or here we have something called Inventaire. It's a project where you can basically say, I have all these books and I'm willing to give them away. Now, it is one guy who started this and he didn't have a lot of time, but he wanted something really nice and flashy. So he used Wikidata to build, for example, these author pages where all this information about the author comes from Wikidata, so he doesn't have to curate all this data himself. And this, I think, is the coolest. It's called Ask Platypus. And you can basically ask it anything. Not quite anything, but getting close. So for example, who is the director of Her, the movie? And it will answer that this is Spike Jonze based on what Wikidata has. You should try it out, it's very cool. So what we've seen now is using open data in a read-only mode, right? We are taking open data and showing it. And this is how a lot of institutions also treat open data, read-only. You publish something, and then other people can use it, but they can't really influence it. And I think this is becoming less and less relevant. We have to move to a place where people can actually read and edit the data you have, where they can contribute back corrections and improvements to you. So this is what we can do on Wikidata, of course. There's a lot of edit and add buttons that you where you can go to wikidata.org and actually influence the content. Or you can play a Wikidata game, which asks you a question, and based on your answer, will edit Wikidata. So for example, it will show you the start of a Wikipedia article and ask you, is this a person or not? And depending on your answer, add information to Wikidata. Or when was this person born? And you answer, and then it will add it to Wikidata, which is a very nice thing to do next to watching TV, by the way. And this is probably the most relevant thing for all of you. This is called mix and match. When you have a catalog of interesting things, people, and so on, that you have an identifier for, you can put it into mix and match, and then together with other people, match it to the data that is in Wikidata. So to be able to say, this concept in my database is the same as this one in Wikidata. And it then adds the links to your database to the pages in Wikidata so that people can find your collection. Also a very nice thing to do on the couch. Yes. And this is, it's a bit hard to show, but basically this is a part of a tool called the Primary Sources Tool that was developed for the migration of another big database that you maybe know, Freebase. Google decided to close Freebase and donate the data to Wikidata. And in order, the data quality wasn't always up to what Wikidata expected, so they had to introduce a human curation step in between that. And if you enable this tool and go to Wikidata, it will show you suggestions like the second identifier for music brains here. And then people can say yes or no. This is good data, this is bad data, and add it to Wikidata or not. So if your data isn't entirely clean, then you can use this to put a human curation step in between, so to say. There's also the Connected Open Heritage project by Wikimedia Sweden, who are working on putting cultural heritage data into Wikidata. Maybe the Wikimedia Sweden people can wave, can sit up. Yes. Talk to these people, talk to me afterwards. So if you want to get involved in Wikidata, there are a few things to keep in mind. The first one is become a part of the community. Don't just stand by the side. Go in, become a part, discuss with people, make great things happen. They're really nice people, and we love cultural institutions. I think this is the biggest area where people work on in Wikidata. So you're very welcome. Working in the open is messy, but it is rewarding. All of the things I've showed you are only possible because this is an open project, because people can contribute. Data, code, editing, all kinds of things. If you do something cool around Wikidata or really any other open project, share your achievements. It's really important for these projects to show what you can do with them, how you achieve amazing things by using them, by contributing to them. And the last point is good data is used. There's no use in data that is just lying around and no one looks at it. So make sure your data is actually used. People build cool things with it, build cool visualizations with it, apps, whatever. This is Wikidata right now, and I hope you will help us light up this map even more. Thank you.
Thank you, Lydia. Right, so I'm going to start with a stupid question. So, because I have never, well, I use Wikipedia, but I've never edited anything. So, how big?
You
is,
should.
Yeah, maybe I should actually. How big is the community? I mean, how do you know in numbers? How some of you might know this, but I have to ask this.
So right now we have about 17,000 people who do one edit a month. So yeah. I'm quite happy with that number, but I would be even happier if all of you added to that.
So do you have numbers, like global numbers? I mean, is the community bigger in the US and in Europe in reference to, what about the global sort of spread of?
Since Wikidata as a development project was started in Germany, there is quite a lot of people in Europe. The next I would say is the US. and then the rest of the world.
Okay. Right, so do we have any more, maybe more specialized questions? I did the beginning question. Yes, please.
You recommended people to join your community.
Yes.
My point of view would be more that you should recommend people to, in this context, to join local heritage associations and then share the knowledge on Wikipedia.
Okay, so the suggestion was join your local heritage community and then join Wikidata.
I was assuming you already do stuff like that. If you don't, you should. That's correct.
And if anyone wants to ask the question in Swedish, I can translate. That's no worry. Don't hold back. I actually didn't see the hands. How many in the room were using, were being part of the Wikimedia? Can we do that again? Is that 50%? How many people in this?
Who edited before?
Yeah,
raise your hand again. Yeah, that's
quite a big crowd.
It's a very decent number. You should be proud of yourself.
Is there anyone who would like to share why that's a great thing to do? Yes, please. Okay, that's good. Yeah, okay.
That's correct, and that's the only reason why Wikipedia exists, because some people have this inner urge to do things right, so you're in very good company.
Yes, please.
Do you think it's a problem with the industries that telling us things they want us to know on Wikidata? For example, Swedish forest industry telling clear cutting is very good. Do you understand?
So, was the question around whether the industry uses Wikidata to?
Is it a problem with the people from industries telling things in the Wikidata?
Right. So, is there a problem if industries choose to edit on Wikidata or give information to Wikidata and sort of form our?
Right. So just like on Wikipedia, it's an open project. So in principle, anyone can come and put anything into it. In theory, it's a bit more complicated than that, of course. There are a lot of editors who screen incoming edits and so on to make sure that the quality is high. The other thing is, of course, that Wikidata is built on the idea that there doesn't have to be one truth. It doesn't have to be just one way. If some company says this is the way, then that data can be added with a reference to, I don't know, some publication by that company. And at the same time, someone else can come and add pretty much the exact opposite with another source. And then when you look at it, you can decide, okay, who do I trust more here? Who has the more convincing arguments, so to say? In practice, it doesn't happen too often, though, because while data is absolutely not neutral, it is much less contagious than the text on Wikipedia, for example.
Okay. Thank you so much, Lydia. So we actually are a bit... So we're going for lunch. Yes, applause. So we're going for lunch, but it's in 10 minutes, so please seize the moment to talk to each other and discuss. Perhaps take the chance to ask Jane and Lydia questions before they leave. Thank you. And we will be back at 1:15.